quick study of Amos. Just found it interesting. Interesting words for us to look at in regards to flat earth. And I guess in regards to no force also, perhaps. Okay, let's jump right in. Amos, the minor prophet, small prophet, wasn't minor in fact, he was just small and prophets, not any big, any smaller than Isaiah or Jeremiah, or just smaller books. Okay. Here we go. Amos. Okay, Amos chapter 9, verse 2. We'll go ahead and start. Chapter 9, verse 1. I saw Yahweh standing upon the altar, and he said, smite the lintel of the door that the posts may shake, and cut them in the head, all of them. And I will slay the last of them with the sword. He that fleeth of them shall not flee away, and he that escapeth of them shall not be delivered. Verse 2, though they dig into hell, thence shall mine hand take them. Though they climb up to heaven, thence will I bring them down. Climb up to heaven. If heaven is right above the earth. Obviously this hasn't happened yet. Happen in history. I mean, this is long after the Tower of Babel. So here we go. We're going to check in on that. They climb up to heaven, thence why bring them down. This is spoken of in Job 26, Jeremiah 52, we'll start there. Wherefore, behold, the days come, saith Yahweh, that I will do judgment upon her graven images, and though all her land, and through all of her land, the wounded shall groan. Though Babylon should mount up to heaven, and though she should fortify the height of her strength, yet from me shall spoilers come, saith spoilers come unto her, saith Yahweh. So, that has not happened yet. This is Babylon as a type, because That already happened, and they're talking about something that is yet to happen in Amos. And also in Jeremiah. It's obviously. That was a foretelling of something else that would happen. So back to Jeremiah 2. Though they climb up to heaven, thence will I bring them down. Let's go to Obadiah 4. Obadiah only has one chapter 1. So verse 4. Though they exalt themselves let's start with verse 2. Behold, I have made thee small among the heathen. Thou art greatly despised. The pride of thine heart hath deceived thee. Thou that dwellest in the cleft of the rock. Whose habitation is high, that saith in thine height, who shall bring me down to the ground? These are the Kenites. This is speaking ahead of time of Antichrist. Though they exalt themselves as the eagle, this might be a reference to the United States, and though they set thy nest and though thou set thy nest among the stars, thence will I bring thee down, saith Yahweh. Interesting enough, this is the last thing Alexandria wrote in a book before he was killed. Alexandria from Russia. The last in the bloodline from the family of Judah, from that particular group of Russian family from Judah, of royalty, that is, when he was killed and his one daughter supposedly survived in America in secret, or she says she did, nobody ever believed her. You can look it up on the internet. There was the whole family was murdered on the road trying to escape from Russia. Obadiah is totally a prophecy about Edom, which many say is Russia. So how interesting, we're talking about that they will set themselves amongst the stars, that he will bring them down. Okay, back to Amos. Okay. In this chapter 9, okay, verse 3, and though they hide themselves in the top of Carmel, I will search and take them out thence, and though they be hid from mine sight in the bottom of the sea, thence will I command the serpent, and he shall bite them. And we know that snakes do not live in the bottom of the sea. But many people say there are